Calloway, he knows better than keep me waiting on Sunday morning. But I got to be out here for my goodness, cats and dogs all over the streets. No, clean up these streets the way they're going on now. I'm going to tell his wife as soon as I see her in church, mind you see me with my Sunday clothes on. People cleaning the streets and everything.
Gonna see my Sarah. Gonna see my Sarah. Gonna see my Sarah for the sun
go down. I've been looking every place for you.
When the big clock chimes,
you're gonna make us late for church.
But Aunt Hagen, I was just playing.
If the open hymn is late starting again, your papa's going to... Now, what's that?
I bought it. Last week, I keep it hid under the porch.
If your papa ever finds out about that thing, that you give it here. If, don't you tell him I knew about this thing. Come on, Larry. Come on, boy. You know how your father is about that opening hymn. Now, you know better than the whole house like that. You know, you'd have more trouble with him when he gets out here. Go ahead, go in there.
Meanwhile, I must admit that I'm very well pleased concerning the results of the late membership drive. Now, on next Tuesday night... of worship with such sacrilege. There are only two kinds of music in this world, the devil's and the Lord's.
Amen.
The only kind of music that pleases God is his own music.
Yes, sir.
Sacred music that sings his praises.
Right, right.
Amen.
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 May the Lord forgive you for turning his sacred song into a tune for evil jigging. William, what's your excuse for being late this morning?
Well, Papa, Charles, it wasn't his fault. It was mine. I couldn't find my hat.
You've kept your hat in the same place, in the same closet for 7 years.
Woman's got a right to change things around. I got tired of it there, so I moved it. And I couldn't find it. That's why we were late.
Well, it's not to happen again. You understand, Will?
Yes, Papa.
It's a bad thing for any church member to be late for worship. For my family, it's unforgivable. I do without. Your whole family does without many things. So there'll be money to educate you when the time comes for your college learning. You are going to be a God-fearing, respected man who is a credit to the Lord, to his people, and to me. I will have it no other way. Do you hear me, Will?
Yes, Papa.
You will go to college. Think of that. Your grandfather was a slave. He had to get his learning without any help. But he became a servant of God and was the first man of his race to be ordained a minister in his state. It will be easier for you than it was for him or for me. And I will be so proud that I...
God, no more.
William! William!
I was only listening, Papa.
Charles, you know how he is about music.
Yes, the devil's music. I talk of the Lord and he listens to Satan.
No, I don't listen to him, Papa.
Even while I'm speaking, you
dare... No, Charles, now he didn't mean it. Now, Charles.
Shut your mouth, woman.
But Charles, you know, he's been warned.
I bought it. Honest. I worked for it and I saved my pennies. 250 pennies, Papa.
Come on, hey.
There are only two kind of horns, Gabriel's and the devil's. You saved your pennies. Well, I'll save your soul. Listen to me. I promise that the Lord will wreak his vengeance upon you unless you obey his commands. And I take this oath. I will follow your coffin to the grave before I see you become a maker of music for the devil. Come on, Hagar.
From your school in Will Handy.
I just don't enjoy singing with anybody playing the organ but you.
I'm glad to be back, Bessie May.
I admit that I wish that Will had received a call to the ministry and had followed in my footsteps, even as I follow in those of my father.
Bessie May, I keep telling him, everybody can't be a preacher.
And if they were, you wouldn't have nobody to preach to Reb Handy.
But I'm proud to say that he's been offered a position teaching school as soon as it's open in the fall.
Well, you take Elizabeth on home.
And don't be late for supper.
You're gonna have a pretty little daughter-in-law one of these days, Reverend Handy.
It's nice having you home again, Will.
I should be real angry with you. You only wrote to me twice, you know, all last year.
I was kind of busy, but... You're not really angry, are you?
No. How can I be? I'm so proud of you, Will. I think it's wonderful about you being offered that teaching job.
But it doesn't pay enough to get married on.
Oh, it will by and by. And it's a respectable profession.
That's very important to you, isn't it?
It is to any woman, Will. If you love somebody, you want to be proud of him, too.
Then let me tell you what I did during vacations. I played with bands. I even traveled with a minstrel show.
Minstrel show? Does your father know?
No, you won't tell him, will you?
No. No, I won't tell him. But a minstrel show.
But you see, it was a wonderful experience. I traveled to lots of places. I even went to San Francisco.
Oh, I can understand you wanting to see the world, Will, but with a minstrel show?
It gave me a chance to play music.
Minstrel show music, dance music. You know how your father feels about that. He's always done what he thought was best for you. Will. Will. You're not going to throw away all your father's hopes for you, are you?
Don't worry.
Now we
make it. Make it $1. $1 to you. Good. Get you $1. Hello, Will. How's the schoolboy?
Hi, Bull Neck.
Finally got back from that Logan, huh?
Got my cornet?
I'll charge you rent money for stealing this horn.
I'll take a sarsaparilla, too.
Sarsaparilla. He ain't even a big spending customer.
Crap, now I'll shoot. I got enough. Look out the way.
Too much noise again.
Wouldn't be if you was winning.
Is he a musician?
Is he a musician?
Well, I need a 5-piece band tonight, and I'm paying
$10. $10? I guess you'll get one together.
Well, then be at the corner of Beale and Jackson tonight at 8 o'clock. It's a political rally. Mr. Bale is running for sheriff.
Oh, yeah, Bale, you know, that's a reform guy. He's gonna reform everything.
Well, maybe you could make up a little song, sort of tell the people what kind of a sheriff Mr. Bale would be.
Yeah, that's all he does, mister, make up songs and drink that sarsaparilla.
To be the sheriff, there's just one man you should elect. Man you should respect.
You something like that?
Yeah.
Do not fail to vote for honest John Bale.
Cleaner, better Memphis, for justice without tyranny, vote for John Bale for sheriff. I thank you.
First money I made in a week.
Boy, I love this long green lettuce. Mm-hmm.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, did you hear that song? I wrote it.
How do you think your father would feel, Will, if he saw you playing on a street corner?
I guess he'd like it.
Did you see about that teaching job yet?
There's plenty of time for that.
School opens in 2 weeks.
I'm thinking about it.
Well, Henry, I don't think you want to teach school. I think you'd rather stand on a street corner and play the cornet.
Elizabeth, don't go getting mad.
Well, how do you expect me to feel, Will? You just made it pretty plain that you don't want a steady, respectable job.
There aren't any real steady jobs for musicians.
No, and there never will be, because there's nothing respectable about being a musician.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth.
Hey, Will. Are you married to her?
No.
The way she talks, that's the way my wife talks to me.
Say, fellas, I got an idea. Why don't we go over to the Big Rooster and play for throwing money?
That's right. Yeah.
Let's go.
Got nothing else to do tonight.
Ain't got no friend, no
got no friend nowhere. Lord, all by myself, no one to
care. That was very nice, baby.
Yeah. How come we don't have any people?
Play it low, boys.
Close up now, Blake.
Who's running this place, you or me? No business anyway. Closing time, folks. Sorry, boys. We'll be closing up for tonight.
Relax. I invited them. What were you playing? I never heard it before.
Oh, he just wrote it.
Oh, a songwriter. Got any others?
There's one I wrote today.
Will's always writing songs.
Does it have lyrics? Play this for me. And remember now, chantez les bars.
Chantez les bars? What does that mean?
It's Creole. It means sing 'em low.
Elect, you see, the sheriff must be a man you all respect.
What's going on around here?
If I'm ever going to get where I want to go, I need good songs, and this is a real good one.
Do not fail to vote for honest John Bale.
All right, that's enough. Hire them.
I don't need a band. If you want the song, I'll buy it for you. I'll give you $10 for it. All right, 20.
Thanks, but I'm gonna try and get this one published.
He's crazy.
Hire him and the band.
We already got a piano player. I'm not having a band in here.
You're not gonna have a singer in here either.
You and your boys want a steady job playing in here?
You mean steady, like every night?
Yes, every night. I'll pay you $2 apiece.
You done hired yourself a band, mister. How about it, Will?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I made the offer, Go-Go. If he doesn't want it, sure not my fault.
He wants it.
Well, you see, my father...
You need a singer who can sing your songs better than anyone else. Now, that Bale song... With different words, it could be a good song.
Different words?
Mm-hmm. Who cares about bail? You could do all your work here. I can come down during the day and sing your songs for you. We could work here during the day together, undisturbed. You might turn out to be the best songwriter in the whole country. You'd like that, wouldn't you? Now let's hear that song again.
To be the sheriff, there's just one man you should elect. You see, the sheriff must be a man you all respect. So do not fail to vote for honest John Bale. No, do not fail to vote for honest John Bale. Like a book, indeed, I know the route that rider took. Every cross town, Bayouburg and Bar, way down where the Southern crossed the Dove. Every kitchen there is a cabaret. Down there, the boll weaver works while the farmers play. The livelong day, dear zoo, your easy timer struck this burg today on a southbound rattler side door Pullman car. Seen him here, then he was on the hog. Gotta stay away, so he had to vamp it, but the hike ain't far. He's gone where the Southern crossed the Yellow Dog. He's gone where the Southern crossed the Yellow Dog. Yes, he's gone where the Southern crossed the Yellow Dog.
Gentlemen, that was Yellow Dog Blues, written by our up-and-coming composer, W.C. Handy.
You didn't answer me. What are you doing that keeps you out so late every night?
Oh, you know.
No, I don't. And that's why I'm asking. And your papa's due to start asking soon, too.
Look, I'm a grown man now. I can stay out late if I want to. I'm not getting in trouble or anything.
There's trouble? And there's trouble. The boy's up to something.
Love, oh, love, oh, careless love.
What's that?
A song I wrote called Careless Love.
Careless Love?
Yeah.
Now, what kind of love is that?
William Handy?
Yes, sir.
The William Handy who wrote Yellow Dog Blues? My name is Mawson. May I come in?
How do you do?
I do.
Now, Handy, I'm an attorney. I represent a music publishing firm that's authorized me to pay you $50 for that song.
$50?
That's our usual payment for music rights. Now, if you will sign right here, I'll pay you the money now.
Is this all there is to it?
That's all. My client doesn't believe in wasting time. 30, 40, 50. There you are. That's right. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
$50, Aunt Hagen, this is just the beginning.
Yeah, but Will, put me down. I will stop it. Stop it, Will. Put me down, Will.
I'm going to go right out and buy you a present. What do you want?
I don't want you to buy me anything. Now, don't buy me anything.
Why?
Will, don't burden me with anything I can't explain to your papa.
But when he finds out how much money I can make writing songs.
Will, you worry about when he finds out. Now, listen, honey, I know you love music. But you think about that careless love. And don't you get careless.
thought I told you to go get the car.
It's in the alley.
You gone sweet on that man?
The only thing I've gone sweet on is the music he writes.
But baby, we told him we'd be there on time.
I like that. You're a big talent, Will. Your music is going to make us both famous. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
I don't know. I never thought about it.
That's right. Don't. I can do enough thinking about it for both of us.
Say, Gogo, where are you from?
St. Louis. Ever been there? Lots of pretty girls in St. Louis.
They lost one when you went away.
If I were a little bird, I'd fly from tree to tree. I'd build my nest way up in the air, where the bad girls could not bother me.
Want to try one?